I would like to share with you how I remember the power series for all these functions, and we will also talk about the radius of convergence and the interval of convergence, and hopefully this right here can help you with your calculus 2 class. So check this out. First, let me tell you that all these right here, they all have the series as n goes from 0 to infinity. So let's just go ahead and get that done. Okay, good. And now I will tell you that the best friend here and e to the x here, they are not alternating, but the other ones are. So let's go ahead and put down negative 1 to the nth power here and negative 1 to the nth power here, and likewise for sine and also cosine. Next, we are going to use the even odd function property to help us out. Starting with cosine, we know cosine is even, and we are going to have the even factorials on the bottom, namely 2n, and then we put the factorial right here, and we have x to the 2n power. Notice that the power right here match with this, but of course this right here we do not have the factorial. And then sine is odd, we are going to have the odd factorial, so put down 2n plus 1, factorial that, and then we have x, and again this and that match, we have 2n plus 1. Inverse tangent is also odd, and this and that are very similar. In fact, it's just the same thing without the factorial. So we just have 2n plus 1 and then x to the 2n plus 1 power. Okay, for natural log, it's not even and it's not odd, but we do have all the natural numbers on the bottom. And because n starts with 0, so we will have n plus 1 here, and we have x to the n plus 1 power. And now let's finish with our best friend. Of course, this is just a geometric series. We get x to the nth power, and to finish e to the x, well, this is not alternating, we just have 1, and we are going to see all the factorials, so we get n factorial here, and then x to the nth power. So you see, we are done with all that. Now let's talk about the technical part, and that is the radius of convergence and also the interval of convergence. Starting with our best friend, this is just a geometry series, so the radius of convergence is 1, and the interval of convergence goes from negative 1 to 1, but we do not include the endpoints. So open parentheses for them. Next, for natural log of 1 plus x, well, r is equal to 1 as well, and the interval of convergence goes from negative 1 to 1, but we do not include the left endpoints right here. We do include the right endpoint here. One easy way to see is that, you see, if you put negative 1 into the x here, 1 minus 1 is 0, ln of 0 is not defined. So we do not include negative 1. However, we do include positive 1, because if you put positive 1 into this x here, this series does converge. So we can allow to put the 1 into here and here, and in fact, we get the alternating harmonic series, and that goes to be ln 2. And then next, we have inverse tangent. Well, this right here, r is also equal to 1. So you see, we have 3 ones right here. But the interval of convergence for this, it does go from negative 1 to 1 as well. And we include both endpoints. Next, for all this right here, let me tell you, r is just infinity. And with that said, the interval of convergence is just negative infinity to past infinity. And likewise, we have infinity for the sine, and then again, interval of convergence goes from negative infinity to infinity, and r is infinity here, and I is going from negative infinity to positive infinity. One easy way to remember is that, you see we have the factorials on the bottom. Well, that's a good hint to tell you that r is infinity. And with that being said, I just this. So let me know what you guys think. This is how I remember the power series. Hopefully it helps. If you guys need to see how we come up with this right here in details, check out my other videos for that.
Then you can pass calculus, I know you can.